Hello everyone, my name is Tyler Krohn-Piatek from Coley at Canisius College. This is the second of a two-part video series on Microsoft Sway. The first video was on some basic tools in Sway, and this video will be on some advanced features. Just as a quick recap of my Sway from the previous video, I have a background image, my title right here, my logo, and if I scroll down, I have a text card, my embedded YouTube video, a slideshow, and an embedded quiz. In this video, I will show you how to create a stack and embed a YouTube video two different ways. We will also make a few sections to help with organization, and we will finish the video off by customizing the theme of our Sway. I'll click on Edit in the upper right here to get back to the Edit Sway window. And then, if I'm not already here, I'll just scroll down to the bottom of my Sway until I find the last content card of my Sway. I'll click on it, and then I'll click on the green Insert Content button at the bottom. The first thing we'll do is we'll add our section. So under Suggested right here, it's got Heading 1, and I'll click on that. You can now see that in the upper left it says 1-Section, and I have a content card, which is very similar to the initial content card that we have up here. I can also tell that this is a new section or group because of the gray background behind the content card. So I'll just add a title here. I'll click on Emphasize to make the text bold. And you should also note that in the upper left, instead of saying 1-section, it now has 1- and my title, homework and due dates. If I want to create content cards outside of the section, I need to either go up to one of the content cards that are outside of the section, or create a brand new section. For now, I will just add a few other content cards to Section 1, Homework and Due Dates. The first thing I will add is a text card. I'll click on Insert Content and go to Text. And you can see that when I went to Text, I now have Heading 2 right here. And this is so that I can create subsections of my sections. We won't do that in this video, but it might be a good thing to note for later on. I'll just click on the text card right here to insert some text. Also note, again, I have these two rectangles. The smaller one is for smaller text, and the larger one will make the text a little bit larger. I'll keep this one small for right now, and I'll add another text card, and I will do some numbering and maybe emphasize that. When I'm done, I'll just add a new section, and I can do that in a couple of different ways. I can click on the green dot here and choose a heading 1, or if I hover over just below my section, I see this little green line right here that I can click, and the same thing will appear. I'll click on heading 1, and this time I'll title this one Introduction. Now you might be confused. Introductions are supposed to go at the beginning of a presentation, not after the homework and due dates. So let's move this section to the top of my Sway. To do that, I need to hover over any empty space to the right of where my section title is until I get this white bi-directional arrow. Then I can click and drag my card to the top. I'll put it right underneath the title card right here, and I can see where I'm putting it because of this green line that appears. And there we go. You can see that it added the content that was originally outside of a section automatically into this section too, which is great. I can also see if I go back to the top of this section, it no longer says 2-introduction, but rather 1-introduction. And if I scroll down back to my homework and due dates section, it now says 2-homework and due dates. If I want to, I can also rearrange the cards in my section right here. So for example, maybe I want the video right here below the slideshow, which I will just zip up by clicking on this little black arrow right here, and I'll click on the video, and I will put that underneath the slideshow. If I want to, I can take a text card from here and drag it up to the content card here. However, I won't do that. Let's add a few more content cards to our section 1 here. The first will be a video card on using Google Drive. I'll click on the last content card that I have here, and I'll click on the plus sign at the bottom. Or since I know I want this video to be above the How to Use Google Calendar video, I can click on Group Slideshow right here and click on the plus sign here to insert content. I'll click on that, click on Media, and choose Video. The menu will appear on the right, and I can click on the drop-down in the upper left and choose YouTube. Then I can click on the search bar in the upper right here, and I can type in Introduction to Google Drive and see what that brings up. This one looks like a good video, so I'll click on that, and I can either drag it in to where it says Drag Video here, or click on Add in the upper right. Once I'm done adding my video to the video card, I can just simply exit out of this menu by clicking on the X button in the upper right underneath where it says Insert. So I have my condensed view of the video card. I can quickly add a caption, change the emphasis right here by clicking on one of the rectangles. And remember, emphasis is just how big the text will be. And in this case, it will also include how large the video player will be initially. Note that all YouTube videos have the option to select a full screen view. So I'll just type in a caption really quick. If I click on details in the upper left, I've got my caption card, but I've also got another alternative text card right here. The content that has populated the alternative text seems to be the description from the YouTube video. Quickly going to look through this and see if there's anything that I need to get rid of. For example, any links that will send the student away from the video or outside of my sway, I'll want to get rid of. But I'll leave the timestamps and where it says Google Drive here. When I'm done, I'll just zip up the detailed view so that it's back in the condensed view. Next, I'll add a slideshow, and then I will turn that slideshow into a stack. I'll scroll up until I see my previous slideshow, and I'll just click on that, and then click on the Insert Content button again. I'll go to Group, and while I do have the option to just go right with a stack, I want to show you how to change a group to a different group without having to create a brand new group or by deleting your media that you already have in your group. So I'll just choose Slideshow for right now, and then I'll click on where it says Add Image. When I do that, I have two options, Add Image or Upload. I'll choose Upload so that I can upload content from my computer, and I will choose some pictures from a previous tutorial that I did. Note that you can upload up to 20 images at once. Any more than that, and you'll have to upload a second set of images. Also note that depending on how many images you decide to upload and how big those images are will vary how fast it loads onto your sway. Also know that if you choose to upload a video or audio file into this group, it will not work.
You can only use text cards and images in groups.
Although I have the option to create a group right here, instead what I'll do is I'll scroll to the top. I'll grab the first image, which you'll also note that these are all checkboxed right here. That means that they are selected. And I'll just drag them up to where it says Add Image. This won't always happen, but I believe because I uploaded a lot of pictures at once, it just decided to upload it to the sway and have them selected instead of adding them to the group here. You can also see that these are now all image cards with the name of the image as the name of the card. I have captions, focus points, and if I click on details, I have everything that I had when I was doing the background image from the previous video. I can also change the title of the card if I need to, but for now, I'll just leave everything as is. We'll change this from a slideshow to a stack. To do this, click on the empty space next to the title of the group. You'll get a bunch of options to the right, including the emphasis, to ungroup all the pictures in the group, and group type. I'll click on group type, and you can see from the right a menu appears from which I can choose the type of group, including stack and grid. If I scroll down, I have also several other options for slideshow that weren't in the original slideshow category. I'll just choose stack for right now, and as you can see, instead of saying group slideshow, it now says group stack. I also want to add a title card to the stack, which I was not able to do with the slideshow. So I'll click on the image card right here, click on the plus sign, and click on text. I'll go off to the right-hand side where there's some empty space here until I get the bidirectional arrow, and I'll drag this to the very top of the group. Now I'll just zip up the group so that it's a little easier for me to scroll up and down. And there we go. I've got a group slideshow and I've got a group stack right here. I've also got the emphasis rectangles again, and this will just show how big the pictures are initially. There's also the option in the bottom right of the stack, which we'll go over later on, so that I can zoom in on the pictures and have it work like a regular slideshow would. In Sway, I can also embed other online content, so long as I have the embed code for it. In this example, I'll show you how to embed a YouTube video, as getting the embed code for a YouTube video might be faster than trying to search for it using the right side menu and searching for the video in that little search menu. I'll open up a new tab and I'll go to youtube.com and find a video that looks interesting. This one looks pretty good, so I'll click on share in the bottom right here, and then I'll click on embed, and then I'll click on copy. When I do that, I can see that I have link copied to clipboard, and I can just exit out of this and exit out of the tab. Next, I'll scroll down, and I want this embedded video to be between the Google Drive introduction video and how to use Google Calendar. So I'll click on that, and I'll click on the plus sign below the Google Drive video. I'll click on Media in the categories and choose Embed. Then, right here where it says place your embed code here, I'll just click there and paste my code in. For me, since I'm on a Windows computer, it's Control V. For Mac users, that will be Command and V. Now, I don't get a preview of the embed card like I do here, but I can also set the emphasis, delete the embed card if I want to by clicking on the trash can, and set it so that it's the original size of the video. For now, I'll just leave it at a small emphasis here. If you're interested in embedding other content, take a look at the Canisius Wiki for some ways to embed Google Forms and or other Microsoft 365 documents. You can embed other online content if you want to, if you can get the embed code. Also note that not all websites will work with this, and in some cases, it may also be easier to simply create a text card and pop the link to your video or online resource here instead. The Sway is for the most part ready to be shared, but before we do that, let's make a custom design so that this looks a lot more interesting than your normal Sway would. In the upper left, you have Storyline, which is what we are in right now, and this is what you use to create your content cards and the basic layout of your Sway. To the right of Storyline, we have Design. This is how we are going to customize the look and feel of my Sway. I'll scroll to the top since I'm not there already, and we will note that Design will give you a pseudo view of what your Sway looks like, but it will also allow you to create and edit your own style by clicking on the styles icon in the upper right. You may also get a pop-up saying that if you want to see how this will really look to people you share it to, click on play, but we'll take a look at that later on. So I'll just click on styles for right now, and the menu will pop in from the right. I can click on remix, and Sway will randomize the style. I can click on remix as many times as I want until I find a style that I am interested in editing. After that, I have these three options here: vertical, horizontal, and slideshow. These are different layouts that you can use for your navigation. If I choose vertical, I'll be able to scroll up and down like a normal web page. If I choose horizontal, I'll be able to scroll left and right, and also use these left and right directional arrows. And if I choose slides, it'll act like a regular slideshow, where I have to use these directional buttons right here. Horizontal is kind of interesting, so we'll just stick with horizontal. Next, if I didn't like the remix, I can choose one of these base templates that they have, or if I'm interested in editing the theme that was randomized for me, I'll just click on customize right here. You can choose the color palette, and by default it's set to curated, which means that Sway will automatically choose the color. You can also choose custom color or select one of your images of your Sway, and Sway will create a color palette based on the image. I'll choose the logo that I have, and I can see if I scroll down, I have a lot of different color palettes now. This one looks kind of good to me. If I scroll down further, I can choose font combinations. So right now it's in Choir Sans and Universe, but maybe I'll choose Renee McIntosh in Universe instead. That looks pretty Art Deco to me, so maybe I'll use that. I can also set the animation emphasis, so this is how often animations will happen, which don't get shown to you in the preview here, except for the slideshow and the stack. I can also set the font size. I'll leave it at normal right now. When I'm satisfied, I can click on back right here, and this will take me back here. And if I'm done, I'll just quickly preview it and see how people I share it with will actually see this. There's my first animation right there. And like I said previously, I've got this little full screen menu right here, and I can take a look at my stack and make it look like an actual slideshow. Got a link right here, my introduction to Google Drive, student sharing, how to use Google Drive. Also, if I want to navigate my different sections, I can click on this little button right here, and I've got my home, which is the start, my section 1, and my section 2. If I'm satisfied with how my sway looks, I can click on share in the upper right. Note, you might have to move your mouse around a little bit to get this menu. By default, it will set it so that those in your organization with the link can view it. For now, I'll just choose anyone with a link can view it. And I'll just copy the link by clicking on this gray button to the right of the link. Then I can add it to my D2L course page as a link and embed it in D2L that way. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, please email us at helpdesk@canisius.edu. Thanks for watching and have a great rest of your day.